Now, I will solve problem number 1.50 for you. Let's read the problem statement. A solid body starts rotating about stationary axis with angular acceleration. Angular acceleration is beta naught cos phi. Beta naught is a constant vector and phi is angle of rotation. Beta naught is constant and phi is angular displacement. Theek hai na? From initial position, find angular velocity of body as a function of phi. Draw the plot for this dependence. Angular velocity as a function of phi. Now, once again, I will write the definition of angular acceleration first. This is angular acceleration. Angular acceleration. This angular acceleration, it would be defined as d phi by dt and its beta naught cos phi. एक स्टैंडर्ड कंसेप्ट हमने समझ रखा है, देख रखा है, मैं एक और बार उसको रिकॉल जरूर करा दूं. व्हेन एवर एंगुलर एक्सीलरेशन इज गिवन एज अ फंक्शन ऑफ एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, द स्टैंडर्ड ऑपरेशन दैट वी डू इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी राइट डी ओमेगा बाय डीटी एज अ फंक्शन ऑफ फाई एंड व्हेन दी वी मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइडेड बाय एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट टर्म. And then this d phi by dt is written as omega d omega by d phi as a function of phi. And then omega d omega is a function of phi into d phi. And then we integrate it on both the sides. This is the standard operation that we had studied in the theory. Hamesha aisa karte hain. यह एंगुलर एक्सीलरेशन हो या लीनियर एक्सीलरेशन हो, यदि यह एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट या डिस्प्लेसमेंट के टर्म में दे रखा है तो हम ऐसा करते हैं, पहले डी ओमेगा बाय डीटी, फिर डी फाई से मल्टीप्लाई डिवाइड, एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट से मल्टीप्लाई डिवाइड करते हैं. वही काम हम इधर करने जा रहे हैं, डी ओमेगा बाय डी फाई इंटू डी फाई बाय डी टी इज इक्वल टू बीटा नॉट कॉस फाई. और फिर मैं d phi by dt को लिख दूंगा ओमेगा. सो दिस इक्वेशन वुड रिड्यूस लाइक दिस, ओमेगा d ओमेगा by d phi इज इक्वल टू बीटा नॉट cos phi. अब मैं d phi को ऊपर ले जाऊंगा और इस तरह से इस इक्वेशन को लिख दूंगा, ओमेगा d ओमेगा इज इक्वल टू बीटा नॉट विच इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट cos phi d phi. And then I'll integrate it on both the sides like this. Initially, when phi is 0, omega is 0. When phi is phi, this sum omega naught. And its integration is omega square by 2. I'll write it like this, omega square by 2. From 0 to omega, and its integration is cos phi, its integration is sin phi from 0 to phi. So this would give me omega square is equal to 2 beta naught sin phi, or omega is plus or minus under root of 2 beta naught sin phi. This is the desired answer, the desired result. Now, they're asked to plot for it, to plot for phi versus how angular velocity and angular acceleration varies with phi. So, first of all, it's under root of sin phi. Phi could never take negative value. Phi must be always greater than equal to 0, less than equal to 2 pi. Phi can never take negative value. Sin phi, in fact, up to pi. Sin phi must be always positive, or sin phi must be greater than 0 and less than equal to 1. Negative nahi ho sakta. Hence, I will say here I will plot for phi. This is phi equal to 0. Here we will have pi by 2 and here we will have pi. Now, first of all, let me plot for omega versus sin phi. Omega versus sin phi would be something like this, elliptical. Sin phi would be something like this. Let me draw it neatly. It would be like this. When this phi is pi by 2, it would take the maximum value, and that maximum value would be plus under root 2 beta naught or minus under root 2 beta naught, and it would take 0 value at phi is equal to pi. And if I plot for, this is for omega. If I plot for beta, this value would be like this. This for beta. When phi is 0, it's plus beta naught, and when phi is pi, it's minus beta naught. This is the value, and it's a 0 when angle phi is pi by 2. Observe this graph and observe the complete solution once again. The definition of angular acceleration, d omega by dt is beta naught cos phi. And when angular acceleration is given in terms of as a function of angular displacement, you multiply and divide it by d phi. You multiply and divide it by d phi, and then d phi by dt can be written as omega, and this function would reduce as omega d omega by d phi is equal to function of phi. Wahi kaam humne idhar kara hai. Angular acceleration as a function of angular displacement, d omega by dt, pehle likha ho d omega by dt ko d phi se multiply divide kar diya, d phi by dt ko omega likh diya, omega d omega by d phi is equal to beta naught cos phi. Humne rearrange kar diya, d phi upar le gaye, phi ke sari terms ek saath, omega ki sari terms ek saath, omega d omega ka integral omega square by 2 aur cos phi d phi ka integral sin phi, limits laga di and we get the expression for omega. And then we plot it like this. Please note it down.